Hi everyone and welcome to Motographer Channel. I am Barry Xia, photographer and content creator. I am going to share in this video about the new Shark Spartan Carbon GT and the comparison with my Shark Spartan Carbon. To find out more, keep watching. First of all, I want to give a shout out to IRIDIUM Specialties for providing me the Shark Spartan Carbon GT for this video. And just to share a bit that I first get my first helmet actually from IRIDIUM Specialties when I'm a 2B rider when I was riding Phantom. And I have been still getting some of my gears there. My recent track day, track course that I went for my YCRS, I also got the track suit from there. So you can go and check it out what gears they have that you might want. So now let's get to the Shark helmets. Alright, let me share a bit of the experience I have in my Shark Spartan Carbon. Basically, it is this is the first carbon helmet I have. The previous was a modular, and I had one LS2 helmet as well. But that one is not carbon, that one is just full black and it is just heavier. So when I wear this, I find that it is much more lighter, especially because it's carbon. And I use it for my touring, I use it to tour up to KL, I use it on the Sepang track, and I'm quite happy with the lightness of it. So I won't really have much strain on my neck, and also it's a good fit to my head shape, which I actually shared in my previous video on how to choose your helmet. The thing about this helmet is only the visor replacement. So later I'll share with you a bit more and how Shark have finally revised the way they actually replace the mechanism to replace the visor have improved in the new Shark Carbon GT. Alright, for both helmets, they actually have the Shark Easy Fit lining inside. So even you wear glasses, don't worry about it. You can actually still wear your glasses while wearing this helmet. So you put on your helmet, you wear the glasses, you won't have the pressure press at your temple area. So you don't need to worry about, oh, will there be any pressing or what. For both helmets, they don't have this issue. So this is my experience with my Shark Spartan Carbon. For the new features of the Shark Spartan Carbon GT, basically is the, I checked, is the hybrid of the normal touring helmet with the track helmet in between. So the new features that is quite obvious is actually the helmet visor lock. It's over here, the helmet visor lock. And of course the side mechanism. Okay, the side mechanism for Shark helmets, previously you have to actually pull them out. It means that you have to put them in a certain angle and you have to pull out. Well, that actually made me broke two visor, and so you just imagine if you're doing that and you are in KL, you have to ride without a visor. So yeah, so fortunately now they actually have a kind of the lock, a plastic lock thing that you can actually just release and then remove the visor easily, just like this. There's a bit of a lock, unlock here, and the other side, just release, pull up, it come out just so easily, just like this. Okay, you can see that how easily it is. So I just want to pop it back. I can just pop it back this way, just push it in, slot it in. After I slot it in, I will just lock this back. Push and lock. They got a separate lock now. So just push and lock. And that's about it. You can see how simple. But for the Shark Carbon, the Spartan Carbon, well, it's not that simple. So sometimes when I remove, I was like, bopi. I mean, po heng sui, in a way that you need to really try your luck. So that's what I don't like about the previous version. And this has a visor lock, so you know it will actually lock it down when you are actually riding long distance or with strong winds. This really helps instead of you having the air just like the dust trying to seep in at the edge, you know. So with this, right, it actually lock it down. But of course, because I'm used to the side opening from my previous helmet. I'm unable to find for this center part. But now I'm used to it. Earlier I was trying my way to find this lah. So okay, it's quite easy, no problem. Then other than that, the top ventilation air ventilation cover is actually bigger, so it's actually easier when you're wearing your glove. You don't need to find for the button or for the small little switch to on the ventilation. So, and also behind there is actually a small vent as well. For the Spartan Carbon, we do not have the rear ventilation, only this has it. So it actually have more breathing, more cooler air going in. But I find that both helmets have, both are well ventilated in my opinion. And because our borders are closed, I'm unable to really try this in higher speed and in much more open expressways. So I cannot comment so much about that. And other than this, now they come with a chin guard, okay, that it can be removed or you just place it in. Previously, the Spartan Carbon actually have a collapsible chin guard. So I guess Shark will find it that it's either you have it or you don't have it, you know. So with the chin guard, it will be also quieter. But I tested both of them in Singapore roads. For this helmet, it's way more quieter because of the neck roll. There's actually more protection over here. And because of this extra protection, it is also slightly a little more heavier compared to the Carbon Spartan. So this neck roll have a good seal, so you won't have a lot of air brushing across inside lah. All right, one thing about this helmet on the visor part is that there is this popping up area, okay, of the visor, which I kind of like a bit OCD, but if you really don't care about it, it's okay, you can focus on the road. But it's just that I feel that while I'm riding or what, with the visor open, I will see there's a little top popping out. Maybe it's just me. I just cannot stand it. But that is one of the key features of it. So I think maybe it will take me a while to kind of like get used to it. So yeah. And okay, for those of you guys who already bought the Shark Spartan Carbon, so don't worry, I have already checked with Rija Specialties that parts are still available for it. So if let's say your visor need replacement, you need replacement for your inner lining, it's still available. So you do not need to worry like, oh my god, I already buy the Spartan Carbon and now you are talking about the GT, then how about the parts for it? Okay, so don't worry, the parts are still available. Alright, now I am going to share a little, this is a bonus review, it's something a bit different, but I will share it anyway because I requested for Iridium Blue visor, and I find that it has other better features because actually I just requested for it for just the look, you know, when you take photo and when I do video for bike reviews or this thing, it just look nicer. But in the night, for night riding, it is way more clearer and brighter as well. So I am quite impressed with it. And the best part is LTA compliant. Okay, it looks a bit like chrome feel, but your eyes still can be seen if you actually look closer. I put my hand over here, you can see that it's actually quite clear. But then in the day, there's a certain reflection, so it looks like full chrome, but it is not full chrome, it is actually still visible. So for those who are interested in getting this helmet, and I suggest maybe you can get this. It's very, very useful for night riding, especially if you ride frequently at night. This will really bring up your focus. So yeah, I would highly recommend for it, okay, for you to get this. So for more about this helmet, I put a link below for you to actually see and what else to purchase if you are interested. And hope you like this video, and I see you in my next video.